Śrīmad Bhāgavatam, Canto 4, Chapter 25, Verse 33. Na vidāma vayam samyak kartāram puruṣarṣabha ātmanascha parasyāpi gotram nāmacha yatkṛtam. Na, do not, vidama, no, vayam, I, samyak, perfectly, kartaram, maker, purusha rishabha, O best of human beings, atmanah, of myself, cha, and parasya, of others, api, also, gotram, family history, nama, name, cha, and yatkritam, which has been made by whom. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. Translation: the girl said, O best of human beings, I do not know who has begotten me. I cannot speak to you perfectly about this, nor do I know the names of the or the origin of the associates with me. Please repeat. The girl said, O best of human beings, I do not know who has begotten me. I cannot speak to you perfectly about this, nor do I know the names or the origin of the associates with me. Purport. The living entity is ignorant of his origin. He does not know why this material world was created, why others are working in this material world, and what the ultimate source of this manifestation is. No one knows the answers to these questions, and this is called ignorance. By researching into the origin of life, important scientists are finding some chemical compositions or cellular combinations, but actually no one knows the original source of life within this material world. The phrase Brahma Jignasa is used to indicate an inquisitiveness to know the original source of our existence in this material world. No philosopher, scientist, or politician actually knows where from we have come, where we are, why we are here struggling so hard for existence, and where we will go. Generally, people are of the opinion that we are all here accidentally, and that as soon as these bodies are finished, all our dramatic activities will be finished and we will become zero. Such scientists and philosophers are impersonalists and voidists. In this verse, the girl is expressing the actual position of the living entity. She cannot tell Puranjan her father's name because she does not know from where she has come, nor does she know why she is present in that place. She frankly says that she does not know anything about all this. This is the position of the living entity in the material world. There are so many scientists, philosophers, and big leaders, but they do not know where from they have come, nor do they know why they are busy within this material world to obtain a position of so-called happiness. In this material world, we have many nice facilities for living, but we are so foolish that we do not ask who has made this world habitable for us and has arranged it so nicely. Everything is functioning in order, but people foolishly think that they are produced by chance in this material world, and that after death, they will become zero. They think that this beautiful place of habitation will automatically remain.
ॐ अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपः कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरो श्रीयुता पदकमलं श्रीगुरुन् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगणरघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakhan Vitamscha He Krishna Karuna Sindho Dina Bandho Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vanchakalpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhya Eva Cha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Namo Vishnupadaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Sunyavadi Paschati Deshatarine Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare So, when we are asked what our identity is, we take out our identity card or passport and say that this is my name, this is my father's name, this is my mother's name, this is my city of birth, date of birth, everything. So we think we know who we are. But the girl is saying here, I do not know who has begotten me. We know our father in this life, but actually that is not the real father. The real father, Krishna says, Sarva yonishu kaunteya murtaya sambhavanti yah tasam brahma mahadyone rajam aham bija pradah pita. In the 14th chapter, it should be understood that all species of life, O son of Kunti, are made possible by birth in this material nature, and that I am the seed-giving father. So he is actually the father. But because we do not hear the words of Krishna, so we do not know actually who our father is. And also she says, I cannot speak to you perfectly about this. The scientists, they speculate about their history, about their origin, about their past. But they cannot speak perfectly. They say Big Bang, they say evolution theory, natural selection. They have many theories, but none of them really answer all the questions. There is a book by one disciple of Srila Prabhupada called Forbidden Archaeology, where he has stated all the evidences, archaeological evidences, that man and beasts, they were existing millions of years ago and simultaneously. But this is forbidden, this is not shown, because it doesn't tally with their theory. So instead of finding out the fact, they try to hide the fact to suit their explanation. So this this is called cheating. Out of the four defects of the conditioned soul, cheating propensity is one of them. Brahma, Pramad, Vipralipsa, Karanapatav. Vipralipsa means cheating. Where is it mentioned? So the four defects are also stated in a verse in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. This is the two times actually it is mentioned. Brahma, Pramad, Vipralipsa, Karanapatav. Ishwarer Vakya Nahi Dosha Esaba. The material defects of mistakes, illusions, cheating and sensory inefficiency do not exist in the words of the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
You see, these four. And then it is stated again. Again it is said, 286 in the Adilila. Second chapter, 86th verse. Brahma, Pramad, Vipralipsa, Karana, Patav, Arsha, Vijna, Vakyanahi, Dosha, Isab. So, Arsha means of the authoritative sages. Vijna, Vakya, in the wise speech. So, mistakes, illusions, cheating and defective perception do not occur in the sayings of the authoritative sages. So, not all sages again. Authoritative sages. like the Mahajans are mentioned. Swayambhu, Narada, Sambhu, Kumara, Kapila, Manu, Prahlada, Janaka, Bhishma, Balir, Vayasakir, Vayam. So, Swayambhur Narada Shambhu Kumara Kapilo Manu Prahlado Janako Bhishmo Balir Vayasakirvayam Dvada Shaite Vijanimo Dharmam Bhagavatam Bhataha Guhyam Vishuddham Durbodham Yajnatvamritam Ashnute Yam Jnatvamritam Ashnute. Lord Brahma, Bhagavan Narada, Lord Shiva, the four Kumaras, Lord Kapila, the son of Devahuti, Swayambhuvamanu, Prahlad Maharaj, Janak Maharaj, Grandfather Bhishma, Bali Maharaj, Sukadeva Goswami, and I myself know the real religious principle. My dear servants, this transcendental religious principle, which is known as Bhagavad Dharma, or surrender unto the Supreme Lord and love for Him, is uncontaminated by the material modes of nature. It is very confidential and difficult for ordinary human beings to understand. But if by chance one fortunately understands it, he is immediately liberated and thus he returns home back to Godhead. So, authoritative sages like this. Whereas in the Mahabharata, there is another verse which says, Tarko pratishtha shrutaya vibhinna nasa vrishiryasya matam na bhinnam. So, rishis, they have their own matam, their own philosophy. Like the scientists have their own philosophy. That kind of sages are not classified here. Arsha means the authoritative sages, like these 12 Mahajans. So, whatever Krishna says, or whatever a devotee who has taken shelter of Krishna says, there is no defects. But ordinary philosophers and scientists, they have defects in their words. And there is a saying like that. If you cannot make it, then fake it. This is the attitude of the scientists, cheating. They cannot make it to the moon. Because actually, if you see the historical events prior to the so-called moon landing in 1969, it was actually a cold war between America and Russia. Russia sent their first man into space, you know, they were orbiting the Earth. And Americans' thing failed, it crashed. And then, so there was so much, Americans were lagging behind in the space race. So they wanted to prove the Russians, they wanted to prove that they were superior than the Russians. And suddenly, out of nowhere, they went to the moon. You know, when they couldn't even make it to space properly, and orbit the Earth properly, they suddenly made it to the moon. So just to show that they are superior than Russia. So actually that was the motivating factor of the moon mission. There was no tangible benefit from that mission. They brought back some black stone, some mud, and Prabhupada was laughing at that. I mean, what, moon is shining so much. How can a black stone shine so much? When it is white, then it will reflect the light. When it is black, how it can reflect? It will absorb the light. It's not even common sense physics. In secondary school, we learned this physics. So, they did not even get that right. And then they are saying they went to the moon. So, it doesn't make any sense. So in this way they cheat. They cannot make it to the moon. They fake it. And so many anomalies in the photographs and videos. The shadows coming out of everywhere. If there is like one sun, there should be only one shadow. But there were like 2-3 shadows. So they could not cheat properly. But many people, it was like one of the biggest lies in the 20th century. So, but this is the, and even the natural selection, so-called theory of evolution. And actually it was dumped. Recently it was dumped by the scientific community even. Some people still advocate it because that's what they learnt in school. But even in textbooks it has been taken out in India. Natural selection. This theory of evolution. Because it doesn't match sometimes. Actually it doesn't match at all. So this forbidden archaeology book, there were archaeological evidences of man existing millions of years ago, but it was not shown by the scientific community. So that's not honesty. They're not being honest. So the reality is, they do not know where from they have come. To know our situation, how we exist and why we exist, we should know the history, we should know the present, and we should know what is yet to come. We cannot know this perfectly, but we can know to an extent. For example, in Singapore there are hardly any seasons, but say in India now, it's what now? January, it's winter. So in about 4 months time there will be summer. So I don't have to be a big astrologer or a big Nostradamus to predict that. So it seems like I know the future. But actually it's just a regular pattern that is repeating. It's a regular pattern. So that's how we know the future. And to say that, oh, this man has murdered someone, or he will be soon in jail behind bars. That's not a huge prediction. I mean, it's just, if you know how things work, then you know what is the outcome. You know, based on the current action. So we know the outcome. So, and we can prevent some untoward, just like vaccine. So they first of all find out how a disease is produced, maybe some virus, and then how this virus can be, contracted. Then they give a vaccine. So they know if you do this, then that can be prevented. So we have to know the future of our present actions. We have to know the past which has brought us here. So all these things we have to know, our whole situation in time and space. Therefore, the Vedic histories, the Puranas, the Itihasas, they are giving us historical references of Vedic references where the Lord has come, and even how the creation was made, how great devotees have surrendered to the Lord. This is worthy history. What we are studying here is history lessons. This happened, this Puranjan, this narration by Narad Muni, happened many millions of years ago. But we are studying now. So what is that? That is history. But this history is relevant to our present. What is the use of learning something which has no relevance? Something which doesn't even make sense. And that's how fiction also has come into being. Fiction, they want to write stories, imagination. Previously, one of the purpose actually Srila Prabhupada says that nobody dared to write anything if it is not upheld by Vedic scriptures. If something cannot be like proven by Vedic scriptures thoroughly, nobody would even dare pen anything. But nowadays it's a fashion to write one's own book. Everybody has a New York Times bestseller. So, and he thinks it is very, and sometimes they just write absolute rubbish, which has no material benefit also. So in this way, people first of all do not know where they come from, who they are and where they are going to go, but still they are engaged in topics and inquiries which are unnecessary inquiries. Like, what is the latest movie? What is the point in that question? Who is benefiting? Only the movie star is benefiting materially, at least. He is earning some money, and the theatres which have, you know, the movie, they are getting some income. That's all. And the people who go there, they waste their time, they waste their money paying for the ticket, and they waste their mental process, because they will be singing that song of the movie. Instead of chanting Krishna's name, that song will be stuck in their head for a few weeks. So, you know, this is how it's a waste. These inquiries are waste. But inquiries which are the highest topic, which are of the highest topic, that is very good. Therefore, Sanatana Goswami says, Kayami, who am I? That question is what we have to ask. Who am I? Not like in the Quora or Google. So many questions. Google has become such a powerful search engine because people asking questions, they just capitalize on it. But Brahma Jagnyasa is not going on there. Some Jada Jagnyasa. Material inquiries. Just because some devotees have put some input into the internet, Krishna's message. So therefore, when you type who is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the answer will come out in Google, Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Because devotees have put something. So, otherwise it is just reproduction of people's imperfect opinions. So without knowing, we should not talk. First of all, we should know. So, Sanatana Goswami said, Kayami, Keno Mare Jarita Patroi. Why I am suffering? Who am I and why am I suffering? That is where it all begins. This is called Brahma Jignyasa. Who am I? And why am I suffering? So, our questioning should be to solve our problems. So, first of all, we should know that we have a problem. But if we can't even see we have a problem, then where is our intelligence? Birth, death, old age, disease. Brahma, what is that? Janma mrityu jara vyadhi dukkha doshanu darshanam. Krishna says this is a sign of knowledge. To see that birth is painful, death is painful, disease is painful, and old age is painful. To see this, to have some intelligence to understand this, that is actually a sign of knowledge. But if one can't see, it doesn't matter, you know, everybody will die, everybody will get sick, you know, it doesn't matter, we just enjoy life. I mean, where is his intelligence? How is he solving the problem? He's just trying to hide away from the problem, run away from the problem. They are actually escapists. They are trying to escape the problem. But they call the devotees as escapists. Oh, you are running away from family responsibilities, you are not listening to the parents and elders, you know. They say all these things. They say you are escaping from, you know, all these social responsibilities. But actually, the fact is, the devotees are addressing the problem. Yes, there is a problem called death. So after that, there is a future. And then that future, we have to determine by our present actions. So they are actually addressing the problem. Whereas the materialists, they are actually escapists. Because they are escaping the problem. And they think that to take care of the whole family situation, the social situation, this is the most important thing. They cannot save anybody. Because first of all, they are themselves not saved. If I don't know how to swim, how can I save another person who is drowning? First of all, that's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Janma sarthak kari, karo paropakar. Paropakar means to help others. You help others, but before that you help yourself. This is not selfishness. This is, if I can't save myself, how can I save others? If I want to save someone drowning, from drowning, and I don't know how to swim, so both of us will drown. Instead of one person drowning, now two. I have just increased the problem. So, so-called welfare initiatives by people, without God consciousness, they think they are doing a welfare for the people, but actually they are increasing the problems. Like people want to open schools. It's a good thought. Yes, people should be educated. Fine. But what they should be educated on, that is not considered. They are given education how to, without any God consciousness, and how to just earn a living. Just how to maintain family and how to earn a living. This is what they are taught in the school. Yes, there is some need for earning a living to maintain family. But that is also given in our scriptures. When we study the scriptures, it is not that we are bereft of material facilities. When we come to Krishna consciousness, it is not that we are only studying spiritual life, we are not studying material life. No, we are studying them side by side. You see, Ishopanishad says, you see this? Vidyam cha vidyam chayas tad vedobhayam saha avidyaya mrityum tirtva vidyaya mrityum ashnute. Only one who can learn the process of nescience, that means ignorance, and that of transcendental knowledge side by side, can transcend the influence of repeated birth and death and enjoy the full blessings of immortality. He should know also that devotee is not ignorant of the process of ignorance. The process of ignorance is the material process, the materialistic way of life. So the devotee is not ignorant of the process of ignorance. He very well knows what is the material way of life. They think, you are devotee, you know, you don't know much about, you know, material world, you know, you're innocent. No, they're not innocent. They actually know very well. Because Krishna is the one who created material world. In fact, devotees know the material world better than the materialists. The materialists are just ensnared by the magic of Maya. But a devotee knows exactly the tricks of Maya. You know, there is a show, TV show called Fool Us. Two famous magicians, you know, they sit, Penn and Teller. There is a TV show like this, you know. I think now they are also in the YouTube. So there is a program they do, Fool Us. So if you can fool them with your trick, you get a prize. You know? And the audience hall will be there and they are the judges. And the participants, they come on the stage and perform a magic trick. And most of the time, these two will figure out. Whereas the whole audience enjoy it. They don't know what happened. They just say, oh, it's a good magic, you know, very nice. But these two people figure out. Sometimes when they're too good, then he'll become, then they cannot fool them. They got fooled. So then they give the prize. So there is a program like that. So a devotee, he is like that, who is expert, who takes knowledge from Krishna. He knows exactly the tricks of Maya. Whereas the rest of the world, the materialists, they are just enjoying the magic. And actually it is not just entertainment, you know. It looks like entertainment. The Maya's magic is not just entertainment. It looks like entertainment, but actually it robs us of our real self-interest. Our real self-interest, what is our meaning of life? It just makes us not inquire about these things. Just keep us, you know, just like if the smartphone is not there, if the TV is not there, what will people do? They will sit down and think about life. There is some chance. Previously, there was stargazing at least. You know what is stargazing? We also used to do. Just, we used to go on the rooftop of our house, just sit down and gaze at the stars. And I mean, it's kind of spacing out, but but there is some thought process going on. You know, when you look at the stars, the expanse of the sky, you start to feel, I mean, how small we are and how big this whole thing is, whole grand creation, and then is there a purpose to all this? And I mean, things start happening in your mind if one is intelligent. There is some chance for reflection, is what I mean. It's not that you will get to the answer, but there is at least some jignasa going on. But now, with the phone in the hand, where is the questioning? Just go scrolling and scrolling and scrolling. And so, the if one is occupied, always, materially, and just enjoys, without questioning, stopping and questioning actually what, how everything is, then what happens? Without him knowing, udyannastan chayannasau ayur harati vaipumsam, the sun is rising and setting, and he is scrolling away on his phone. Sometimes he enjoys the sunset, sometimes he enjoys the sunrise, but actually it is just robbing his life. All this is magic. Oh, beautiful nature, this, that, everything. And then in this way, he's just ensnared by the tricks of Maya, and he doesn't see that he is being robbed of his lifetime. Whereas the devotee knows, oh yes, okay. Then he is alert. He's very alert to notice where the Maya's tricks are. That too, it requires an advanced devotee to even see. Even in the beginning stages, you know, we are like completely bewildered. You know, little bit we know, but you know, very easily overpowered by Maya. But therefore, we have to be strongly associated. Tivrena bhakti yogena. We have to be very strongly associated in devotional service. Then we can stay away from this. So it is not that the devotees do not know about material life. They know very well. And they know very well that they have to stay away from it. And they are addressing the real problem. Whereas the materialists, they are escaping from the real problem. And they have taken upon themselves so many pseudo problems, which are not actually their problem. Which are not really their problem. They think it is their problem. Like Gandhi. He thought, if he goes, then the whole India will be finished. But he went. He died. So long ago. India is not finished. Still going on. Hitler was thinking, if I am, you know, without me, Germany cannot run. Germany is running better now. Instead of everybody dying in war, then, you know, there is some peace. So, you know, so this kind of we think, this is called ahankar. Prakrite kriyamanani gunai karmani sarvashah ahankara vimudhatma, false ego. Ahankara vimudhatma kartaham iti manyate. The spirit soul, bewildered by the influence of false ego, thinks himself the doer of activities, and that that are in actuality carried out by the three modes of material nature. The Maya, by its own power through the three modes, Sattvagun, Rajogun, Tamogun, it is acting. And I am just an immediate cause for it. I am not the real cause. I am just an instrument. But I think I am the doer. And I think this is responsibilities. And then one who is running away from that pseudo-responsibilities, the materialists classify them as, oh, you're escapists. You're escaping from problem. You know, instead of serving father and mother, you're going away. No, the devotee, we have showed that in another class. We made a short video of it also. No, the devotees are actually giving, serving their father and mother in the best possible way. By, as Narasimhadev said, just by being born in the family, Prahlad, you are liberating 21 generations of your forefathers, not only your father and mother. 21 generations are going back because of you in the presence. Viprad dvishat gunayutad aravindanabha padaravinda vimukhas swapacham varishtham. This is explained by Prahlad Maharaj. Manye tadarpita. What is that? Pranam kulati. Pranam punati sakulam natum purimana. Manye tadarpita mano vachane hitartha pranam punati sakulam natubhurimana. If a brahmana has all 12 of the brahmanical qualifications as they are stated in the book called Sanat Sujata, but is not a devotee, if he is a very expert brahmana but is not a devotee and is averse to the lotus feet of the Lord, he is certainly lower than a devotee who is a dog eater but who has dedicated everything. Of course, a devotee is not a dog eater. He's coming from a dog eating family. The brahmana, expert brahmana, is lower, certainly lower than a devotee who is a dog eater but who has dedicated everything, mind, words, activities, wealth and life to the Supreme Lord. Such a devotee is better than such a brahmana because the devotee can purify his whole family, whereas the so-called brahmana in a position of false prestige cannot purify even himself. So let alone expert brahmana. Nowadays, family members, they are lesser than Shudras. They hardly follow any brahmanical principles. Simply wear some thread. Those who aren't born in brahmana families, they just wear some thread and say they are brahmanas. They are very high class. Because why? They have a 2 paisa thread on them. That's why they are very high class. There's no consideration of character, habits, and what guna you are in, sattva-guna, rajo-guna, and tamo-guna. There's no consideration. Simply some external symbols, and they judge, okay, this is Brahman. Escapists. So we are not, devotees are not escapists. They address the real problem. The rabbit is an escapist. The ostrich is an escapist. When a problem comes, the ostrich will put his head under the ground. I don't see the problem. Or the rabbit, he just closes his eyes. You mean the animal who is coming and eating, coming and hunting it down, if it closes its eyes, the animal will go away? The animal will not go. If the ostrich puts his head under the ground, the danger is gone, but just because I do not see it, so it doesn't go away. In fact, I will be killed. I cannot even be alert. My eyes are open, I can at least try myself to defend some way. But if my eyes are closed and I'm putting my head under the ground, I am just offering myself for balidan, for sacrifice. So we are, materialistic people, they are like that. They just close their eyes. Oh, you want to slaughter me? Okay, I close your eyes. You do not exist. What happens? I'll be slaughtered. We're just surrendering to the slaughtering process of Maya. Yeah. Therefore, to come out of this, there has to be inquiries. Topmost inquiries. Is it the one? This is something else. So anyway, there's one verse. This is Canto 1, Chapter 2, Text 5. Munaya sadhu prishtoham bhavadbhir loka mangalam yat krita krishna samprashno yenatma suprasidati. O sages, I have been justly questioned by you. Your questions are worthy because they relate to Lord Krishna. And so, are of relevance to this world's welfare. Only questions of this sort are capable of completely satisfying the self. So, questions relating to Krishna and self-realization, these are relevant questions. So, in the Puranas, this Bhagavad Puran, it is a history, but it is a relevant history. The history which is relevant to our welfare. The history which is not relevant to our welfare is not discussed in Bhagavatam. Because there, good things happen, bad things happen in this world. But the Bhagavatam is selection of all the instructive lessons in history of this universe. And actually, in the whole Bhagavatam, 18,000 shlokas, and even all the other Puranas, so much history, right? All this history is just from this one day of Brahma. They are not even of another day of Brahma. And how much history has passed in other days? There is only one reference to a previous day of Brahma, that is Narad Muni. When he was a son of a Sudrani, and he met the devotees, and he ate the Uchishta, the food left by them, Uchishta. So their Mahaprasadam, he ate. And that's how he became devotee. And in this life, in this day of Brahma, he was born as Narada. Other than that, there is no reference to a previous day of Brahma. So all the histories that we have is only of this day of Brahma. So how much you see instructive lessons? And Brahma is already 51 years old. 51 years old, and how many days? Brahma's days. So there is unlimited stock of lessons. So, but the whole point is this, that we have to know who we are, where we come from, who we are now, what we should do now, so that our future is secure. And secure means then you have no fear. Why there is, what is security? Fearlessness. A woman can dress half naked in Singapore and go in the middle of the night without fear. Because why? There is some security. Same thing in India, finish. No security. Fearless. So that is security. So the fearless lotus feet of Krishna, Abhaya Charanaravinda. The lotus feet of Krishna are called Abhaya Charanaravinda. The fearless lotus feet. That means if we take shelter of his lotus feet, we become fearless from this Maya. So that fearlessness is awarded by Krishna's lotus feet. So in order to make our future secure, we have to take shelter at his lotus feet. And that is done through the spiritual master. So therefore, this is the ultimate program that every human being should follow. Ask questions, relevant questions about one's self-realization, and get the answers from the bona fide spiritual master. In our case, Srila Prabhupada. So, any questions or comments on this topic?
Although other days of Brahma's activities are not known to us, it must be ongoing because of the little bit of difference in the past times of life.
Yeah, I mean, repeats, but it is not like stale. Like, for example, even in this day of Brahma, so for those who can't hear it, the question was that even though we do not know about the other days of Brahma, it must be a repetition of the same things. So the thing is that there is repetition, but not in the same way as it's not stale, it's ever fresh. Lord Krishna's pastimes are ever fresh. For example, even in this day of Brahma, he came two times as Varaha Avatar. One is red Varaha, one is Shweta Varaha, white Varaha. So we are in the Shvetavaraha Kalpa. The Kalpa in which Shvetavaraha, in this, every Yajna we do, in the Sankalpa, we have to chant. Before the Yajna starts, we have to chant. Adya Brahmana Dvitiya Pararthe, Tatrado Sri Shvetavaraha Kalpe, Vaivasvata Manvantare, Kali Yuge, Prathama Pade, Jambudvipe, Bharatavarshe, Bharatakhande, Meroh Dakshina Parshve. So this is, and Simhapuri, Simhapuri Nagarantargat, Simhapuri Deshe, Simhapuri Nagarantargat, Avamguna Visheshena, then the person who is doing the Yajna, then what Yajna he is doing. So, in this place, in this time, in this day of Brahma, so I am doing this sacrifice, I am initiating this sacrifice. So, in that way the Yajnas are done, this is called Sankalpa. So, there it is mentioned, Shvetavaraha Kalpe. So, we are in the Shvetavaraha. So, two Varahas came. So, one Varaha, he fought with Hiranyaksha and he saved the earth from the depths of the ocean. Another Varaha also saved the depths from earth from the depth of the ocean, but there was no fighting with Hiranyaksha. This Kalpa. This Kalpa means one day of Brahma. So there is the lifting of the earth, but the reason is different. And even if we see, just now in the earlier beginning of this class, we mentioned the 12 authorities, Mahajans. So that was spoken by Yamaraj. And it was when Yamadutas met Vishnudutas, you know, Hajamil story. After that they came back and then he instructed them. So that was millions of years old. But he mentions Janak Maharaj and Bhishma Dev and Shukadev Goswami. So they came, like Bhishma Dev was just 5000 years old, 5000 years back. And Janak Maharaj was like in the Trita Yuga. And that also there is some, in the Ramayana there is a statement that Lord Ram installed Vibhishan as the king of Lanka after Ravana's death. And Vibhishan ruled Lanka for one cycle of the four Yugas. You know, so whether that Treta Yuga was this Treta Yuga, well, sometimes it is mentioned as this Treta Yuga. So either way, so the history is, how come Yamaraj has mentioned Bhishma Dev? That means Bhishma Dev came before. In a previous day, every day of Brahma, Krishna comes once, then all his eternal associates also come with him. So Bhishma is an eternal personality, Nitya Siddha, who is coming with Krishna every time. So, like that, Janak Maharaj, Sita's father, Buddha also actually. Buddha also two times mentioned. Both times, actually he effectively stopped interplanetary travel. But specifically in this, he came to stop the animal killing and introduce atheism. So when there is atheism, the demigods will not be interested to come here. So all the travel will stop automatically. So they were traveling before. Like Yudhishthira Maharaj, when he performed Rajasuya, they came. Rajasuya sacrifice. He invited the demigods. Like, you know, when there's a marriage, we invite relatives, friends. Yudhishthira Maharaj invited the devatas, demigods, to come down. And they came. And even common men could see the demigods. That is stated in the Bhagavatam. So, but now the travel all stopped. Why? Because Buddha came and he took out all the religious Vedic principles, because he wanted to save the animals, and the demigods stopped coming. No more travel. And another time Buddha came, he also stopped interplanetary travel, but not exactly stop animal killing. So, In what way? Oh, Gajendra was glorifying Lord Buddha. It's because it's already happened in the past. Even Islam, although it started like 2000 years ago, there is a mention in the Narasimha Puran, Varaha Puran, Narasimha Puran, I think Narasimha Puran, that there was a Muslim man who was being attacked by a boar, a wild boar. So for a Muslim man, a pig is haram, you know, it's forbidden. So the boar is attacking him and he was chanting haram, haram, haram. And the pig, the boar killed him with his tusks. And he was chanting haram, haram, haram. And because he chanted ha, Ram, the name of Ram, he went back to Godhead. the power of the holy name, that he was chanting haram, haram, saying haram means condemned. You know, forbidden. Oh, this, you know. So he chanted haram like that. But because the chant, the name of Ram was there, went back to Godhead. Killed by a pig. So this is stated in the Quran. That means Islam existed before, in a previous Kali Yuga. Every Kali Yuga it comes. So this Buddha also comes every Kali Yuga. Either every Kali Yuga or in Kali Yuga he comes. Other universes, not loka. Loka means in this planet, loka. But other universes.
Other universes.
In this universe, only one Brahma.
Other universes also
past time of Lord. Yeah, yeah. Nityalila. Lord's pastimes are always going on and on and on. Prabhupada explained like the time. Right? So now it is 9:15. So 9 o'clock has passed here. Now it is no more 9 o'clock. But in another part of the world, it is 9 o'clock now. So the 9 o'clock is never stopped. 9 a.m. is never stopped. At one place or the another, the 9 a.m. is always there. If here gone, another place is still there. For us, it's like it's gone. But actually, the 9 o'clock never goes. So in different places, it's going on and on, 9 o'clock, 9 o'clock, 9 o'clock. So like that, the Lord's pastimes are always going on, but here it looks like, okay, it's finished 5,000 years ago, Krishna went. But in another place, it is going on. Another place.
Spiritual world, it is
there, is eternal. There, time does not have a bearing on the activities. That means here, everything is time-bound. There it is not bound by time. That is explained in the Brahma Samhita. What is that? Shriya Kanta Kanta Paramapurusha Kalpatarvo Druma Bhumis Chintamani Ganamai Toyam Amritam Katha Ganam Natyam Gamanam Apivamsi Priyasaki Chidanandam Jyoti Paramapita Dasvadyam Apicha Sayatra Kshirabdhi Sravati Surabhi Bhyascha Sumahan Nimeshardhakhyo Va Vrajati Nahi Yatrapi Samaya Nimesha Ardha. That means half a moment of time. Nimesha Ardha. Nimesha Ardha Kyo Va Vrajati Nahi Yatrapi Samaya. Even half a moment does not pass in the spiritual world. In the spiritual world, there is no passage of time like it does in the material world. But still, there is Ashtakalya Leela, for example. The Ashtakalya means, in the day, the 24 hours is divided into Ashtaprahara. Prahara means a period of 3 hours. Prahara. So in the 8 praharas, there are different kinds of leelas of Radha and Krishna. So in the morning they do some things and then afternoon they do something like this. So this Ashtakala means time. Ashtakalya leela. So this is there. But this happens in the spiritual world. Now how? Time does not pass, but Ashtakalya, how it is possible? It is possible because the time passes at the will of Krishna. So he can stop if he wants. If he wants, 1 second he can make into, just like when he was dancing in the Rasalila. It was only for one human night here, earthly night. But he extended, for the gopis it was one night of Brahma. 4.32 billion years they danced with Krishna continuously. And after it was finished, they were like, what, over? Finished? Are you so fast? So, how he adjusted the time So time is completely under his control here also, but here his rule is that it should pass. But there it does not pass, it passes at his will. So time becomes very insignificant in the spiritual world. It does not have the force that it has here. Here, kalosmi lokakshayakrit pravriddho. The whole world is destroyed because of time. Time just passes and we are destroyed. We are dying. Every moment we are just closing, we are going closer to death. But time does not have this power in the spiritual world. It is a servant of the desires of Krishna. Here also it is servant, but it is meant to punish us. There it is. It's completely, so it's different. Time is different there. So any other questions or comments? Somebody asked, what is this? Anyway, it's not a question. So we'll stop here. Granthraj Srimad Bhagavatam ki, Srila Prabhupada ki, Nitai Gaur Premanande.